despite saying that his character sucks.
Yeah.
Every single time.
Every single time. You ask this man, oh, what's good about Bowser? Nothing. It's like, all right, come on, buddy.
Yeah. Omega made a joke on Twitter that was like, Emoticon's first words after being born, Bowser sucks.
Oh, that look on his face. I hope somebody screen caps that.
We got the stank face.
Got the stank face. We're going to be adding that as an emote to playing Discord.
And wow, another HMO on stream. Is this just Balance's stream? Or is this just Tibbs' stream?
Apparently.
We're just seeing all HMO right now.
Because the HMO boys are good, the HMO boys are fierce, and right now they are one away, all of them are one away from making it out of pools. Bad Recruiter, unfortunately, did not win, make it out winner side. Let's see if his brother Pac-Man Tibbs can make it out winner side.
Yeah, and I think this matchup probably a little bit in Pac-Man's favor. Just, ooh. You know, like Bowser, you know, I don't think he's really scared of swords because he has range himself, but when you have projectiles that force him to shield and go into the air, that's where he doesn't like to be. He likes to stay on the ground, you know, use his dash dance and grab range, but in the air, he's just a big hurt box.
And the scariest thing about Bowser that I'm seeing right now is that Wiggy Face ate so many punishes, but you know for a matter of fact that he's going to be the one not closer to death than my man Tibbs is.
Yeah, exactly. Bowser definitely, you know...
What was that? That was like, I don't know if that's Frozen DI or Bowser just being Bowser, but oh my god, he died so early.
Yeah, he said, no, I take 100 damage in disadvantage, but I kill at half the percent. And I call that balanced.
I call that balance. Oh, give me some skin.
Oh my gosh, and, you know, Winky Face making this matchup work for him.
Oh, okay, I thought we were about to see a Ledtron back air or something like around that area. Okay, gets the out smash because the bell has a lot of lag on it after it hits you. So, good stuff by my man Tibbs, but it's also worth noting too that Emoticon does have some experience in this matchup as well. He has played Bad Recruiter plenty of times, so this is not somebody who doesn't know how to fight Pac-Man.
Gotcha. And you know that bell into up smash might have seemed simple, but you're definitely gonna see that on like 5 highlight reels for no reason. Old Pac-Man, big brain.
Mucho brain Pac-Man. I can't believe he hit bell. He just threw it forward and just hit up smash. Crazy.
Okay, like the up. Up B at a shield. I really feel like I see Deluxe do that more than the other Bowsers, but liking Winky Face using that a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, even if you guess wrong, I said once before, Bowser is incredibly heavy. He can take the hits. But who cannot take the hits right now is Tibbs, because he needs to find a way out this corner.
Oh, the extended
up tilt.
Yeah, the extended up tilt. I'm anti-airing you no matter what.
That up tilt is, it's so good. Like, especially at ledge. Like, especially when Bowser respawns, he's intangible. It covers everywhere, above him, in front, behind.
Mm-hmm.
It's a stronger Lucina up tilt.
It covers the whole 9 yards. All right, let's see what's going to happen here. Tibbs has got to make this comeback, but every second that he gets hit, man, Emoticon starts to feel himself more and more.
Yeah, and, you know, again, nobody tonight is letting Pac-Man go to PS2. Like, we are all studied on the matchup, it seems. Starting on Battlefield.
Yeah, starting on Battlefield, good pick for him. And this is about one of Battle's best stages too, because he gets a lot of unique setups on it too. Oh, yeah. Going for F smash, gonna finally die into a force smash, but I mean, if Pac-Man has as much trouble killing as he's shown. Oh, what in the hell?
The reverse hitbox, okay.
The reverse hitbox and just so much stuff, it's just, okay, all right.
But yeah, Bowser, he'll get his shield break setups here. You know, he can get falling up. Nair into stuff. He'll also get that side B that kills early on the platform, so he's got a lot going for him on the stage. But Pac-Man, of course, also has more room to run around, run away from you, and charge his fruit.
Oh, the bait, and once again, I don't know if that's like bad DI or not, but the downer to kill him right teleport, man, you see him all going to face like, oh, I don't know. He's like, you DI somewhere, like left, right, I don't know. I mean, good luck.
Yeah, and the balloon knockback in this game, like, to be fair, it makes teching spikes on stage so much more difficult than it needs to be. Like, so I can definitely like resonate with missing a tech like that and dying off the top. It's definitely happened to me before.
Oh, I agree. Yeah, like, it's just so weird in this game just because the knockback is so strong out of nowhere, and then once you miss it, it's like, all right, I get followed up on, or you just die for some reason. All right, so Tip still sticking with the Pac-Man, Emoticon still sticking with the worst character in the game.
And going to PS2 for the counter pick, not the starter. Yeah, I wonder what Emoticon banned, but I definitely feel like the Pac-Man's all, they all like this stage.
Probably FD, because I think FD might low-key be one of his best stages. Oh, Pac-Man's best stage, to be clear.
Yeah.
Oh, jab resets?
Oh, good damage there.
Yeah, slowly but surely putting the hands on Bowser. Oh, almost gets the punish there. Not going to quite happen.
Oh, just out of range for the side B.
Yeah, my man upbeat out of shield immediately. You're like, no, don't touch me.
I like the flame breath there because of the multi-hits. It immediately gets rid of the platform. But Tibbs sort of punishes the end lag on there.
Oh my goodness gracious. And as I said before, Bulletquan does seem to know this matchup. He does. Okay. He was looking to show us everything right there. You should be able to stomach it back. Bowser's recovery is pretty good.
Ooh. Wow, okay.
Should be fine.
I feel like Tibbs actually could have thrown the orange when Amorokon was up being back, because he did overshoot a little bit. But still has him at the ledge. Wow, he's putting on a lot of pressure in the corner.
Okay, running dash attack, surprisingly no command grab there.
Yeah, and Tibbs going to have to be careful whiffing, because next time it might be the command grab.
Yeah, look at all this rage that Amorokon has on the side, though. Oh, come here, get the SC love. Command grab kills. I don't know if that's proper DI or not, but Amorokon, despite losing all of neutral that game, takes it back from him, but we're down to even stocks for the second game.
Yeah, and you know, that was 10 million IQ. He did belt up smash. 10 million minimum.
It sounds like you have a little bit of spite there, Mr. Yeet Smash Boy.
Like, I don't like to see these Pac-Mans all on my Yeet Smash. Where's my clip of me doing back air? I need more of me. I don't need the rest of DFW on here. Just me. Where's my Yeet Smash video?
You got it.
Mr. Thomas of Yeet.
Okay, extended back air off of the Hydra.
Oh, you don't like the little roast on you? Alright, command grab. Oh!
What was that? It actually saved him!
The platform saved him!
Okay, oh wow, okay, still takes the stock anyway, but that is worthy to note. Amalcon's gotta be wary of that in the future, because Tibbs now has the information on deck.
Yeah, Tibbs. Yo, I want to say it was 100% intentional. He DI'd that way on purpose. And the water pushing him out. Oh, poor Bowser, his punching bag.
Yeah, poor Bowser, the punching bag.
Until he kills you at 30, and then it's like, okay.
Yeah, it's all right. Like, screw this character, man.
Oh, Bowser's low tier.
Okay, tries to get a grab right there. Not going to get anything out of it. Doesn't tech and eats a forward smash because of it.
Yeah.
The interesting thing there is, too, is that if he did tech, he would actually get punished for teching in, actually.
Oh, yeah. Bowser being so wide, and his tech rolls in particular are atrocious.
Oh, yes.
Like, for someone of his size, you compare it to how fast DK moves when he techs, Bowser's is just pitiful.
Yeah, when I was playing Snake, I think I covered two options just off a down throw by just standing still. I just up-tilted, and, like, he just died. I was like, okay, well, that makes no sense. But all right, we live with that. But Tibbs is kind of running away with his percentage lead thus far. He's got near 50% lead.
Yeah, oh my gosh. Yeah, kind of punish the end leg there. Good whiff punish.
Okay, and Tibbs found himself on the board. We are going to game three. Will we see another HMO making it out on winner's side of the pools? Or potentially will he be having to go through losers? We shall see. Amorokon, I said before, makes lots of upsets, makes a lot of our players feel fraudulent. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Yeah, and, you know, with the up smash underneath that platform, I don't think that was, you know, the worst idea in the world, but I think it's just because of Pac-Man's floatiness. He's able to maneuver around that. Because, like, if it's, like, a fox there or, you know, even a cloud, like, you're falling so fast, you can't really get around that in time. So you just have to air dodge out, not punish.
Yeah, and if you air dodge out away from Bowser, Bowser's still one of the quickest heavies, not even one of the, he is the quickest heavy in this game.
Yeah, he'll definitely just react and punish your end leg anyways.
Okay, just gets rid of the Hydra casually.
Yeah. Interested to see how the sleds are going to sort of affect his
ledge
trapping.
Oh my goodness gracious! Whoa. Who cares about ledge trapping when I just got a 50% combo off of you, or 100% combo off you in one exchange?
And Pac-Man is top tier, apparently.
Yeah, Pac-Man's top tier, man. Where is Shinji at, man? Winning all these EVOs and everything.
Yeah, he did top 8 one thing, though, so that's good for Shinji.
That is good for Shinji, but right now my man Tibbs is looking at top 8 Shockwave. If not, take Shockwave, of course. Down air, missing everything in the world right there.
Yeah, very good patience from Amorokon not to go into the grab, because it's very, it was a little bit telegraphed what Tibbs wanted there after he threw the melon.
Okay, you're trying to get an up smash. Not gonna happen. Every second that he does not kill Bowser, becomes more scary as time goes on.
Yeah, he's definitely looking for these up smash on the platform. All right, that's scary. Yep.
Yeah.
What do you do there? It's so much coverage.
Like the it's a good meaty setup. Oh, we're gonna have that big damage again. Doesn't get the is not able to grab the rocket one more time, so he's not able to get that big damage that he got before.
Yeah, still 47%, so nothing to stop at. From the outside looking in, it's like, bro, why are you neutral getting into that ledge trap? But it's like, realistically, what else do you do? Like, Pac-Man can cover so many options at once.
Yeah, he was trying to run for a roll. Oh, nice parry to up tilt. Not going to be quite ending the stock quite yet, though.
Yeah.
That's up? Oh, what the? Okay.
I think that was Bowser's animation, because when he's paralyzed, he's like body swirling and whatnot, and he actually leans back a little bit.
Okay.
Tim's taking the stock anyways, though.
Yes, taking the stock anyways. Okay, big damage. Doesn't get the second grab once again, but that's 40 damage already and counting.
Yeah, Winky really needs to start scouting out these Galaxian ship throws at zero, because he's starting to stock off every single time that way.
Yeah, stock off at zero gets like 100% put on him too. It seems like Battlefield or like a Yoshi Island pick is just the best stage pick for Pac-Man, of course.
Yeah, and Winky, you know, aware of the bell setup there with the fire hydrant, so not gonna fall for that. But still, it's such a huge deficit. This game has just spiraled out of its control.
Yeah,
mainly due to these Galaxian ship combos. They've just been so much.
Oh my goodness, great. Still living though.
Oh my, Bowser ate his Wheaties this morning.
If there's anybody to make this comeback, it's definitely Bowser. Oh, not gonna happen today though.
Oh,
or potentially it might be today.
Okay, a third false finish.
Okay. No third false finish here. They actually got the 1, 2, 3, and my man got the pin. Probably said emoticon to losers.
This coach is saying, stay down. Don't get back up.
Throw in the towel. Oh, look at a beautiful pick of my man Tibbs. The extra zoom in. Oh, Lord. Whew.
Our ultra HD 4K cameras or whatever the heck we have here.
Yes.
This futuristic technology.
Jeez, I had to roll down the stuff, man, because I forgot it is summer out here, boys.